it also depends on who you're influenced by.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, it does. Some people influenced by, let's say, Kid Cudi.
Yeah.
You, Kid Cudi. I think that's what we said last time.
Yeah, we'll have Kid Cudi.
And obviously Kanye, which brings me to Donda.
Let's talk about Donda.
All right. Let's hear yours first before I do my rebuttal.
That is one of the greatest albums that has been made of the last. I'm trying to remember when he dropped My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy.
2008.
Of the last 10 years, then. One of the greatest albums of the last 10 years.
Wasn't that when his mom died? My Beautiful Dark. No, what was the.
That might have been Graduation.
Was it Graduation?
Maybe.
It was like right after his mom died, he came out with that.
No, it was
album.
My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. I swear, I think it is.
I think that's what it was.
When his mom died?
Sometime around.
Something like that.
It was like mid 2010s.
Yeah.
I guess. But, like, man, it's just such a masterpiece of an album. I'll admit, not every song I'm a fan of on it, but there are some songs on there. The thing that I like about Kanye is no album sounds the same. If you play Graduation or Late Registration or
Life of Pablo,
any of them, Ye, Yeezus, all the way to Donda,
no song
sounds the same. And with artists nowadays, it is just such a cookie cutter, copy and paste format. To where you know exactly what it's going to sound like, what they're going to rap about, what the features are going to be, what the beats are going to sound like. And
who's going to be producing it.
Yeah, with Kanye, I never thought to hear a song like Moon on there.
Right.
That was beautiful.
Oh, it was a beautiful song.
It was a really awesome song.
Yeah, I agree.
And you just don't have artists that are getting creative anymore, pushing the envelope. Changing the sound. Like, that's the thing.
Mm-hmm.
Back in, when was Graduation released?
2005, I think.
I'm going to look it up right here. Okay, but Kanye literally changed the entire
format
I mean, of hip-hop.
He did, yeah.
If it wasn't for Kanye, you wouldn't have people like Kid Cudi or Young Thug or all of these artists. Graduation came out in 2007.
I was close.
Like whenever you heard a song called Good Life, you know, or Flashing Lights, it changed absolutely everything. Him and 50 Cent had a bet going on at the time. And it was like, whoever's album sells more, they're going to quit hip-hop.
Right.
And of course, it was
between like Curtis.
Yeah, it was Curtis, 50 Cent's Curtis, and Graduation.
It's not even fair.
Curtis had I Get Money. That was like the big
Graduation
song.
Graduation
had
everything.
Good Morning. It had Stronger.
It had
Flashing Lights.
Yep.
The Good Life. Mm-hmm. I mean, The Champion. I Wonder. Can't Tell Me Nothing. Like. So many bangers. Like, literally. It was one of the greatest albums ever made. And, of course, like, 50 Cent lost, and he didn't quit music.
Right.
But people say that that's the time that hip-hop went from gangster rap to actual pop music like it is nowadays on the radio. If it wasn't for Kanye, you wouldn't have hip-hop on the radio. There was no hip-hop on the radio besides hip-hop stations.
Right.
Yeah.
Like, there was no hip-hop artist breaking into the top 40 until Kanye.
Right.
He killed the gangster rap era with Graduation and started an entire new movement for the genre of hip-hop.
Yeah, because people seen that and they're like, I can do that too. What?
Yeah.
I can try that. We can branch out like that.
Well,
what?
And you heard a song.
And it's still rap?
Well, you heard a song like Good Life.
Yeah.
Or Stronger, you know? And it's like, you can have techno and hip hop.
Yeah.
That's a thing. What is this auto tune? What's going on here? It sounds like they're singing instead of rapping.
It almost sounds like an EDM verse right there. What?
Yeah. It changed absolutely everything.
I love Kanye. Kanye is the GOAT.
I know that he has a bad attitude sometimes, and he's absolutely off the wall crazy sometimes.
There's no one Kanye loves more than Kanye himself.
Absolutely. Yeah,
but, I mean, I just don't know if you could have what he does if he didn't have that type of attitude. That's what has made him great.
Yeah.
Somebody that believes in himself that much.
Because nobody can stop him.
He ran for president.
He ran for president.
Exactly.
He
ran
people voted. Would you love to see Kanye as president?
No.
Okay.
No. I think he'd be a terrible president.
I think I would love to see him just to see.
But, like, I mean, but he had the guts enough to do something like
yeah.
that. But whenever it comes to Donda, I mean, people are going to be talking about that album for years to come. Like, I think there's, like, a college class that's actually, like, dissecting the album.
Oh, yeah. Probably like a music theory class, right?
Yeah, something like that. And what other artist is doing stuff like that?
Right.
Nobody drops an album and then they start a college course about it to dissect it.
Yeah, like we're changing the lesson plan. We're going to dissect Donda until we actually understand every piece of it.
And the thing is, he's still changing it.
Oh, yeah.
Like, if you listen to it on Apple Music or Spotify, it's still changing to this day. Like, I was listening to it driving home the other day, and New Life came on. And I'm like, that's different. He changed the course on it and put a choir in there.
Yeah.
And just, I that's why I love Kanye, because I grew up loving hip-hop for the reasons of the creativity and the pure passion of it. Whenever you listen to somebody like Kanye or Jay Electronica or Kid Cudi, Nas, J. Cole, whatever, like, you got inspired. It made you want to be better in life. You had to really listen to the lyrics. There's a song that J. Cole has called Let Nas Down, where he's talking about printing off the lyrics to his songs, putting them on his wall, so that he could study it like poetry.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what made me fall in love with hip-hop, because it was exciting, and you never knew what was going to happen next.
There's just so much emotion in it, you know?
Yeah, it had meaning. It had creativity. It had passion.
Nowadays, it's just like, I know exactly what's going to drop, and I know exactly how it's going to sound.
It's depressing. All it does is talks about sex and drugs and being sad.
Yeah. Firearms.
Or killing people.
Yeah.
I'm starting to feel like an old man because we're talking about this, but it's like, it's the truth. I finally see what they've been talking about for years.
Cardi B the other day said, it's bad when I'm agreeing with Cardi B. Somebody was asking her about the state of hip hop, and she was just talking about how all of it sounds depressing.
Yep.
And how rappers nowadays need to stop smoking weed and drinking lean, and maybe they'll start making some better music. I think that, like, people are just dumbing down a beautiful art form of music.